warm welcome to the Lake Placid Olympic Ski Jumping Complex, an iconic location from the Olympic Games, and we'll be adding to its rich sporting history today because a new chapter in the sport of Nordic combined will be written. So it's a brand new event for Nordic combined today. It's the mixed team Nordic. Round one is the ski jumping, and then we move to the cross-country track for the final round. We have 12 teams competing, 5 from Japan, 4 from Poland, and 1 each from USA and Kazakhstan. Each team comprises 3 athletes. The Nordic combined athlete will compete in this round and the cross-country round. The ski jumper and the cross-country specialists will only compete in their specialist round. And it'll be fascinating to watch the dynamics of that coming together. Conditions are pretty good, with only the slightest of breezes, which is how we like it, temperature just below 0. We're on the 90-meter hill. If you're new to ski jumping, that means you get 60 points for landing on that 90 meters line. That's the solid red line that you can see. For every meter short or long of that line, or the K point as we call it, an athlete has 2 points added or subtracted. And the total points from today's 2 jumps will affect the starting positions for this afternoon's cross-country race. We're now with Poland 2. Joanna Kill is going to get them underway. Nordic combined specialist already has a bronze medal to her name at these games. It's a good launch. Nice clean landing. And a distance of 76 meters. So on the whole, just looking down the list of competitors, we've got, it looks like the coaches have chosen to put their ski jumping specialists very much in the women's section and have chosen their male Nordic combined specialists to do the jumping. So Japan 2's Ayana Miyazaki gets the go. Good style, good flight. Looked like a long jump as well. 86 meters for Miyazaki. And she really impressed in the individual Gundersen, taking the bronze medal behind 2 of her compatriots. 96.3 will be her total. Kara Larsen, ski jumper from the USA. She's competing alongside Erin Bianco in the cross country. So USA 1 are underway with a jump from Kara Larsen of 80.5 meters. Points not bad, 80.6 in total, that puts them 4th. Nicole Kundela of Poland. Good flight. A good long distance from her. Double gold medalist at these games, and she means business. You can see she's got her eye on gold in this event as well. Good flight. And the judges will have liked the style. And good points from the judges, 115.9, and that puts them top of the pile with a 10-point advantage. Our final female jumper, Machiko Kubota. Again, a ski jump specialist. Already has two silver medals at these games. And another excellent jump. Look beyond the K point, and she will be very pleased with that. 91 meters, so not quite as far as Kundera, but it was good. Quite a bit of movement and shake on that flight, though. There are the points. So the judging points low, 106.9 total, and that puts them, Japan 1, into second place. So the men will now go to the top of the jump. Adam Nizhny, the ski jumper. So our first specialist ski jumper to go in this second round. Proved himself already with the gold in the mixed team event last night. And that is a good jump. Lots of power on the takeoff and a great length. And he can't believe it. He's really happy with that. Good position. Good style. So 91 meters for Nizhny, and some good points, 203.5, that puts them top and by quite a margin. Japan 2's Ryusei Ikeda to go now, the 22-year-old from Hokkaido, waiting for his coach to lower the flag and give him the go. 87.5 was his distance in the trial. Ski's slightly wide, but he got a good jump in. 92 meters. And as the ski jump specialists come through, in fact, they're the only two ski jumpers actually competing in the men's section. All the others are Nordic combined specialists. All right, well, 218.9, and that puts Japan 2 into first place. And now we have the two overall leaders, Poland 1 and Japan 1. Andrzej Szyszczowicz of Poland going next. Mikol Kundera, his teammate, put in a fantastic jump in the first round. Can he do just as well? Good positioning, good flight, excellent landing. He nods, he knows that's a good one. 89.5, so just short of the K point, but really good style. And he will be marked up for that by the judges. 188.2 is their new total. Right, Andrzej Szyszczowicz. Once again, another Nordic combined specialist. Pumps the air, he's happy with that. A good jump from the pole. 85 meters. 209.7 the total, so Japan 2 still top. Right, the last jumper for Japan 1, Sakutaro Kobayashi. Now, high hopes for Kobayashi. He's already got gold in the mass start, silver in the team sprint, gold in the individual Gunderson. Launch, and it's a good jump. There's good length there. Wow, 95 meters. Now Kobayashi, much stronger in ski jumping. than cross country. I'd say he was an all-rounder, but his strength is definitely ski jumping. That's how he's managed to win two gold medals already at these games, by getting ahead, getting that advantage in the ski jump, and that will be his tactic here today. 234.4 points puts Japan top of the leaderboard by a considerable margin of a good 18 points or so. And what that means is that they start with these time deficits. 21 seconds between Japan 1 and 2, Poland 1 in 3rd, Poland 2 in 4th. Doesn't the venue look absolutely fabulous in the lights at night? Now, the ski jumpers, they were key to round one, but they stand aside for this event. And the idea behind this new format is really to gauge which countries have the strongest teams across those three Nordic sports. So temperatures dropping and snow that is falling is drying out, but the track is going to be pretty slushy. It is the men that get us underway here, and Japan won with that nominal advantage of 21 seconds as Sakutaro Kobayashi gets this race underway. And he's known as being a really strong ski jumper, but he has held his own on the track as well, having won three medals here already. Second away for Japan 2 is Ryo Hirose of Waseda University, who's actually a cross-country skier, has already won three gold medals at these games. He'll be trying to chase down his compatriot Andrei Szczechowicz of Poland. Starts with his time deficit. Then we're going to have Poland 2, Mateusz Haratyk. Wearing the number 5 bib from the USA, it's Nicholas Malasinski, looking for his 4th medal at these games. Next up will be Japan 5 with their cross-country specialist Motoki Yamanaka. Oh, and not the best of starts. And we were talking about the slippery surface and his enthusiasm just getting the better of him there. Kazakhstan get away with their Nordic combined athlete, Magzan Amankulduli. Then it's Japan 3 with Nakazawa. Two more teams left to go. We think the winners could come in around about 11 minutes. So that tells you how big a disadvantage it is here, with the USA starting 3 minutes and 10 seconds back with Cameron Wolf. But we're back with our leader, Kobayashi of Japan. And you can see right behind him is the cross-country specialist, 22-year-old Ryo Hirose. It'll be interesting to see if there are team tactics and strategies going on here. Will he try and catch him and stick with him, or will he push ahead? To be honest, the race is actually so quick that it's all about an explosive start, and then the majority of them will just be going out there as fast and as hard as they can. So it's Poland with the number 3 bib already caught and overtaken by Haratyk. So the Nordic combined athlete overtaken by the cross-country specialist. On the attack, Hirose. He was waiting for this. This is the hill that really differentiates the specialists from the Nordic combined athletes. I tell you what, Kobayashi doing a really good job of holding his own. And he's away down the hill.
Team Japan 1 and Team 2
And after this race, we might have to reassess our thoughts on Kobayashi. He's really proving himself now in this sprint. Kobayashi representing Keio University. He's actually the oldest Nordic combined competitor here, 22 years of age. And he's got his cross-country teammate right on his shoulder. Three goals to Hirose's name already in the cross-country. He's having to fight really hard to get past his compatriot. So Hirose closes up the 21-second gap, and now it's all equal between Japan 1 and Japan 2 as the women start their final lap. Rin Subue for Japan 1, and out in front Ayane Miyazaki for Japan 2. So Haratik didn't just overtake his Polish compatriot Szeszkatowicz, he managed to grow that lead as well. And Joanna Kill is away, the only medalist in Nordic combined for Poland at these games. Weronika Kaleta, now she is a cross-country specialist, and you would expect her to be faster than Joanna Kill. So it's all about the advantage now, that time difference, and whether they can close the gap. So Ayane Miyazaki here. As we watch Erin Bianco of the USA on her final lap. USA currently sitting in fifth. So at the moment it's Japan 2 ahead of Japan 1, Poland 2 in third, and Poland 1 in fourth. Ayane Miyazaki in the lead. Trying to chase her down is Rin Subue from Nihon University, 22 years old. And look at this. So Miyazaki, it's almost as if she's not aware that she's being chased there. That is Weronika Kaleta of Poland 1 coming up. Rin Subue. Japan 1. Out in front. So at some point on this lap, we've had a lead change between Japan 1 and Japan 2, with Rin Subue overtaking Ayane Miyazaki. Get a time check in a moment as the chasing pack come through. Kaleta 35 seconds behind. So Poland 1 now into second place. And this is a great run as well from the American Erin Bianco, who's now moved up to third. So the USA have moved from fifth to third. Then comes Joanna Kill of Poland. Out in front, our leader. So it is Japan one out in front with Sabue. In second place, we've got Poland's Kaleta, Poland one. Then comes the USA's Erin Bianco, Joanna Kill of Poland. Poland two is in fourth, and Miyazaki of Japan, that's Japan two, is in fifth. So Ayano Miyazaki, who set off in second place, is really struggling on this cross country and has dropped all the way back to fifth and has lost a minute now on the leader. The big downhill, Rin Sabue, the cross country specialist in this pairing. Will be taking this very carefully as she comes into the stadium. It's not far now to the conclusion of this race. And this is going to be a victory for Japan one, barring disaster. Hugely experienced 22-year-old from Nihon University, Rin Sabue, chooses her lane and heads towards the finish line, where Sakutaro Kobayashi raises his arms. They embrace, and it is gold for Kobayashi and Sabue in this Nordic combined mixed team Nordic. Veronika Kaleta of Poland won. The pair started in second place with a 33-second deficit. But here she is, the cross-country specialist, Veronika Kaleta, coming in to take the silver medal for Poland one. And what a great performance as well from Erin Bianco and Nicholas Malasinski, who started a minute and two back from the leaders to finish for the bronze medal. So another medal for the United States and another one for Japan. This is Poland two, Joanna Kill coming in to finish just out of the medals. And Ayano Miyazaki of Japan too, who started that final lap in the lead, but really, really struggled. Disappointment for Japan too. Another gold medal for Sakutaro Kobayashi. So this is his third gold. He's also got a silver. Confirmation of how they finished then. Japan one take the gold, Poland one take silver, and the USA up from fifth. Well done to the Japanese once again, sealing another gold medal. And what a comeback though from the USA for bronze.